Hey folks, it's James, and remember Bob Ross, the calm voice, the happy little clouds, the magic that made painting look so easy? Well, think of this lesson as Bob Ross, but for architects who are looking for fast, easy ways to take their hand renderings to the next level. In today's draw-along lesson, I'm going to show you how to take a simple SketchUp wireframe and turn it into something almost photorealistic in just minutes. The secret isn't talent, it's a couple of tricks in Procreate that anyone can do. So grab your iPad, download the files that come with this episode at the link below, and get ready to learn a technique that will impress you, your family, and pretty much anyone you show it to. For the first one, let's add a new project, and let's just use our screen size for that, and I'll tap that. And now let's go to our wrench menu, our actions menu, and let's go to the add button, and hopefully you all succeeded in downloading the file today that comes with this. So I called it the week 5 Procreate SketchUp. And I'll open that up. Let's do the Saarinen table first, okay? So I'll tap on that. And I'll tap out of that so the marching ants go away. And I'll just enlarge it so we can all enjoy that. Remember, the goal here is I'm going to make sure that the line drawing is on top of the colors so that the line drawing always is always transparent and invisible on top of the color rather than adding color on top and obscuring some of the lines. So to do that, I'm going to tap the plus button in the layers, and now I'm going to move that down below layer 1. So that's how you'll get your first layer of color down there. And then I'll just go in here and I'll try and find a off-white marble color. It won't be the right color, but I'll start with one, and then I can adjust it later, as you all know. And so for this one, I think I'm going to go back up to the selection, and I'm going to use ellipse selection for this. And as you may recall, when you have an ellipse, the way that Procreate starts the ellipse is it imagines a rectangle around your ellipse. So you want to start the ellipse at the imaginary corner of that rectangle, which is about there. And let's see if I get it right. It's easy enough to do it over again if you don't get it right, but that's close enough for government work. So I'll go ahead now and drag and drop that color into there. That did not work. That's interesting. That layer that we brought in is a JPEG, and it has to be turned to multiply blend mode. And so I'll tap on the blend mode icon, and I'll drag it down to multiply. And now I'll turn off the selection tab. And so now you can see that drawing's still on top, but it wasn't letting the things below it show through. So there's our first layer. And now we're going to add, let's do the marbling on top of that already. So I'll keep it dark, even though I don't think it would be that dark. And I'm going to use the same color that we used for that, and I'm going to go and add a new layer on top of that, and I'm going to put that layer immediately into multiply blend mode. So now that's going to allow me to create the illusion of marble even using the same color, and that marble will show up, and I'll show you what I mean by that. So I'll go to the brush library, but a lot of times I like this script pen for kind of wiggly things like grain that goes in marble. So I'll activate the script pen, and I'll come back out, and as you recall, we're in a new layer that's in multiply blend mode, and I will start. A lot of times I'll just hold my pencil in this kind of floppy way. I won't do it like this because this is me trying to draw too much, you know, holding it in a traditional way, but I just want the pencil to make the shapes that I'm about to make. So I'm going to hold it back here, and I'm going to just start kind of wiggling it through the way that marble would work. And, you know, it helps to look at a piece of marble if there's one in your office. So I might get lucky. I've done this a lot, and we'll see how convincing mine is. But if you press down a little bit harder, you'll also get those moments in marble where the vein got a little bit bigger. And so there's all kinds of ways to do this, and just have fun doing it. Now that's a little too light, So I can immediately go into the hue, saturation, and brightness and make that darker. And I can also desaturate it. Let's say I want more of a gray running through there. So I'll do that and desaturate it. At that point, I can see clearly that the tabletop is the wrong color. So I'll come back into that kind of buff color and I'll make it more, again, I'll go back into adjustments and hue, saturation, and brightness. And I'm just going to lighten that and tone it down a little bit so it looks a little bit more like a sophisticated, lighter marble. And then I want to do one more touch to that. And I did say to you we could do all this in three layers, which technically we could. But because you're all getting good, it's much more fun to do it in multiple layers. And so let's still use that same brush we were using, that same script pen. And I'm going to keep multiplying these layers too because I want to see right through them. And this time I'm going to use that gray that we used, but I don't have it loaded up here. So I'm going to go to the brush menu and let's tap on the color picker. And there you can see it pop up. And just by coincidence, it happens to be on that gray, but you can drag that color picker around and find the gray you're looking for. So this is kind of fun because we're going back through all four previous sessions and picking up random skills. So now I've got that script pen loaded up, and the great virtue of the script pen is that you can press hard at times and then lighten up and then press hard at times. And I don't need it to be that big. But I'll find some comfortable number. And now I'm going to do that trick. I can come in here and do a terrible version of that, but as long as I hold it down at the end, I'm going to get a perfect portion of a circle. So I'll undo that, and then I'll just practice a little bit more, and as my coffee jitters disappear, I get closer and closer to what I'm trying to accomplish. I can just keep practicing for the fun of it, and as long as you hold that tip down at the end, you'll get that final arc you're looking for, okay? So I'll stop there. That's good enough for me. And then let's go in. Now let's do the brass table, the brass base of the table. So I'll add a layer. And it may be that I want that layer below the tabletop just because it happens to be physically below it in life as well. So I think I will move this brand new layer. I'll tap on it and hold and move it down below the tabletop. And now I'll come up here and pick sort of an orange brown. That's going to work for me at first, at least. So I'll come in and I'll pick the selection tool. And this time I'll start in freehand mode. And I'll pick up the top of the table. And notice that I started up in the marble because it'll be hidden by that layer. And I'll come down and I'll tap and I'll stop there and I'll just do my best version of a freehand ellipse right now, and I'll use the eraser later if I mess it up, or I'll add something to it if I mess it up. So I've gotten that far, and now I can stop, and then I can go back to my clicks again or my taps. And I'll come all the way up. I won't stop down here. I'll just tap all the way up here because it's all going to be hidden by this marble tabletop. And I'll close up that shape. And then I'll just drag and drop the bronze color over. Okay. And at this point, I would typically go look at an actual piece of bronze and realize how far off I was. And I'd probably, in this case, let's guess amongst ourselves. And I'll go to hue, saturation, and brightness. And I think that probably the particular bronze that Saarinen used for this was probably darker and less saturated than the one that I picked. So I'll start there. And now I'm going to add some highlights to that. So I'll add a layer above that because I'm always going to build on these layers. And remember, we darkened that bronze, but that original light color is still back there. So I'm going to go with that. And I think I might even stay with a script pen. And I'll just kind of put in a highlight of some kind. It's probably not one you'd find in nature, but I'll just see. I'll start fat and then taper it. And then I'll come down here like it's a little highlight along the edge of that. And then I'll flare it out a little bit more where the light would spread out when it hits that conical shape. And then I'll just kind of do, this time I'm going to do one of our curves again. I'm going to start a curve up here and pretend that that's one highlight. So maybe that's a light in the distance that's glinting off the raised edge of this table base. And I'll do one here like that. And let's do like that and stop there. And that curve is taking hold. And maybe I'll just add a few dots like that. And then again, this wouldn't be in nature, but I might even just sort of add a gentle arc there to just kind of pronounce that part of the table. So I'll leave that at that. And now the table itself is going to cast its shadow down onto the ground. And let's go to our original ellipse. And let's tap on it and then do a right to left duplicate to it, a right to left swipe, and duplicate it. Now go to the layer that it's the original layer, but go to the layer that it was on the bottom of all that, okay? And what I like to do again, because it's going to be hard to see it since it's light, is I'm going to go ahead and just kind of darken it completely so I don't lose track of it. So again, I'm in the lowest of the duplicated layers. I'm going to go to my adjustments menu, and I'm going to just randomly turn the darkness all the way down, the brightness all the way down, okay? So when I start moving it, I'll see it clear as day. And now I'm going to double check that I'm there, and you can see ahead of time that it's already there. So now I will go to the Move tool, and I'll just start moving it down. And it's not going to do anybody any good like that, because it's at the same foreshortened angle as the top of the table, but it happens to be down here where the shape of any ellipse is going to change. So now, just by eye, I'm going to make sure I'm in freeform, and I'm going to stretch it. And this is definitely a thing you've got to have to call by eye, but it has to look more like a believable shadow cast by something like that. So I'm about there, but I can still adjust it later. And now what I'll do is I'll go and turn it into multiply blend mode. And so I'm tapping the blend mode icon, and I'm going to move to multiply. Now it's still incredibly dark because I have to do another operation. I have to lighten it now. So I'll go up to adjustments, and this is the fun part now. When you lighten this, now you see it come alive, okay? And now you'll, for the first time, you'll be able to actually see if you really got it right, if you got the proper amount of darkness or even the proper shape, but it'll come much more alive now. And the fun thing is you can move it around. So if once you've got something close, you can just go back to the move menu, move and transform, and just play around with it. But you can see why I wanted it to be slightly off center, because I wanted to see the contrast of the brass base. But just that can suddenly bring it alive. And then if we go back in now and change the background color just for fun, and I'll change it to a red, and you can see it really just brings the illusion alive like that. The funny thing about that is once you get into the background color change, you can just keep hitting things, so that's really cool.
Before you head out, don't forget to download the original Procreate file that comes with this lesson. You'll find it in the description below, and that way you can replay the steps, study the layers, and practice at your own pace. And if you want to go deeper into this workflow or learn other techniques architects and designers use every single day to save billable hours, check out the learning resources linked in the description below. To keep the momentum going, click here to watch the next draw along in this series, and I'll see you in the next video.